They flew off. The blackbird's really going for it. Anyway, actually whilst I'm waiting for Will, let's have a look at how Town's looking. It's a lovely morning. I don't know if I should admit to this, but I like it when there's this haze of chimneys with smoke. Everyone's got their fires going. Actually, and it's also a bit of fog, to be fair. A bit of fog settled in the valley. I've just sat in Will's car. We're off on a overnight trip to Will's parents. So we'll be there for a couple of nights. I might try and film some of the stuff there, but mostly I'm there just to have fun. Shame those birds flew off. Anyway, in other news, I'm hopeful that the piano tuner will come this week, so I'll let you know if that happens, how that goes. I'll leave it there for now, and I will see you in a bit. Town. Another day, another town. Just waiting for our windscreen to be repaired after we've got a chip in it. Nice hills over there. It's quite nice standing here watching the world go by. All these people, where are they off to?
Not quite as fancy as that mini one that I had my eye on. Look out, so that goes there like that. Something folds into that.
I'm off out on an early morning stroll, place where I'm staying. And I have the pleasure of being able to borrow someone else's dogs for a few days. I love dogs. It's nice to be out in the early morning. It's not as cold here as it gets at our place. There's a slight frost there. It's one of those clear, crisp, bright mornings. Good doggy. Lovely view from up here. We're headed this way. Welcome to Thursday. I'm starting on the piano this morning because I've got some bad news. The piano tuner has been and gone and was unable to tune the piano because he didn't have the appropriate tool. So because the piano is quite old, it's about 1860-1870. It's got a different shaped pin. It's got an oval shaped pin rather than a star, which I think is the more normal shape. And he had the fitting to go on the pin, but he doesn't have the right tool to go onto the thing that goes on the pin to give him the right leverage to be able to tighten it. So he doesn't even own that piece of equipment, so he's going to see if he can source it and then maybe see if he can come back. And otherwise, in the meantime, Will and I are going to be investigating whether we can find another piano tuner. So no joy with the piano. Still. Still out of tune. But anyway, we'll get there, I think, because I love this piano and it's worth for me to pursue it. I'm just sat on the front doorstep about to undertake a project that I do intermittently. Now, you may have noticed that, good girl, when it comes to the equipment, actual tools, my car, but also down to my very clothes, any sort of work where I hammer pretty hard, I'm not precious about it. But I do like to take care of things, and what I'm about to do is clean my boots. Don't worry, I'm not going to teach you how to suck eggs, but these are important. Well, it's not so much cleaning them that's important, but what I'm going to do is clean them and waterproof them, and it's the waterproofing that's most important to me. These go through a lot, so I basically wear them every single day. I do a lot of hard work in them. I do chainsawing in them. They're steel take-ups, but you know, they're a bit sawed. But the thing that's really bad at the moment is just, this isn't going to convey it, but it's just so wet underfoot. Wet and... bye, Rita. Wet and sticky, and getting wet feet when it's also very, very cold is just misery-inducing. So that's a project I'm about to do, get them nice and re-waterproof. This is my kit. I'll just quickly talk you through it. So essentially, I'm going to use the brush to brush it off. I'll have the brown brush to brush it off. I've got this Aaron Williams boot polish. And then I've got this water-resistant, basically dubbin, but a Lee degree, which I will then put on top of that. So that's my task for a few minutes. Not going to win any beauty prizes, but basically I put the dubbin on the waterproofer. You could see it was sort of quite waxy because it's so cold. I had warmed it up slightly on the range, but then the boots were cold as well. So what I do is I put that on, and then I hover my boots over the hot part of my range till the waterproofing wax melts, and I rub it in. And then I'll keep my boots under the hot part of the range to allow the wax to settle in even more, and then I'm good to go. Before I go this week, I thought I'd just quickly show you a project I've started. Actually, let's reverse and put it into some context. So essentially, The kitchen worktops are made out of wood, but in the wisdom, the person who did this decided it would be a good idea to varnish the worktop, and the varnish is all peeling off and is pretty grim. And I can sort of live with it on the worktop that's around the sink, although I'm not going to leave it like that. But it was very unpleasant on the worktop where we make our food. So after polishing my boots today, what I did was took my various sanders and I've sanded it all down, and I've put some tung oil, T-U-N-G, food grade oil for wood. And this is what I've achieved. All that nasty varnish is gone, the orangey discoloration is gone, and now I've got a lovely kitchen worktop. I'll need to put a second coat on tomorrow, and then essentially that's good to go the day after tomorrow, so on Saturday. It takes a while for the oil to sink in. And then at some point in the future, yeah, that's a bit better. At some point in the future, I will do the same for this. So essentially, I've gone from this to this. See you next week. Bye.